Starting. All the other clips are still on one. It looks like he reversed the diagonal because of black getting stuck on the peg.
Shot.
Please help yourself with it more than we can. Oh, very good.
nothing to a sandwich or bring you a plate of food.
Sure.
There is a pretty heavy pasta salad over there. There's chicken salad with great pinto pecans in it and potato salad. And
the chicken salad sounds good.
Do you want a sandwich or that?
Sure. Okay. That'd be great. Thank you so much. Okay. Brian apparently did not move the Peely in front of four back, and Robert elected to leave the balls where they ended up. So red is for four back, yellow is for five. And blue and black, I think, are still for one. I read an article about that somewhere.
Yeah.
pavilion.
Huh?
Yeah.
Can't get any closer.
Oh my goodness. While the battery was changing, he had tidied yellow and then rushed red up a three back, which he just failed. And yellow and red are on five and four back, respectively.
Thank you. I had one that I had a cocktail in that 44 Magnum.
Really?
Unbelievable. I mean, it's like a mule. But, you know, I right there.
He has an easy three-back Pioneer. I think he meant for Red to hit the hoop. Interesting escape. So, yellows for three back, reds for pinot. Blue is for three back, and black is for one. We can probably find some first graders to show you how. So electing to stop at four back and give a rush for black to try to get going.
Very aggressive. Thank you.
So while I was changing battery, he made hoop five and rushed to the east boundary. Try for the peel before hoop six. And he got it. Looks like the Peely's probably going to two back. Didn't get the rush back to Pinot, obviously. He did Roquet Red. Looks like it's a leave instead of trying to finish the peel. The triple. On this turn, anyway. So blacks for the peg, blues for rover, yellows for three back, and red is for pinot.
Thank you.
26-18, Robert Hurst over Brian Cummings.